नायंग देह देहु भाजांग निलोके कष्टान कामान अर्हते वीर भुजांग जे तपो दिव्यं पुत्र का जेना सत्तं शुद्धि जस्मात् ब्रह्म सौखम अनंतम। दिस इवनिंग आई शैल रिसाइट सम वर्सेस फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम फिफ्थ कैंटो फिफ्थ चैप्टर ऑन द इंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ऋषभदेव। ऋषभदेव वॉज द फादर ऑफ किंग भरत आफ्टर हूज नेम दिस ट्रैक्ट ऑफ लैंड इज कॉल्ड भारतवर्ष। सो ऋषभदेव बिफोर रिटायरिंग फ्रॉम फैमिली लाइफ ही हैड 100 सन्स एंड ही इंस्ट्रक्टेड देम अबाउट स्पिरिचुअल रियलाइजेशन ऑफ लाइफ। दिस भारतवर्ष लैंड ऑफ भारतवर्ष इट इज मेंट फॉर स्पिरिचुअल रियलाइजेशन। श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु हिज मिशन इज टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट द मैसेज ऑफ भारतवर्ष थ्रू आउट द होल वर्ल्ड। ही सेड it is recorded in a Bengali stanza, Bharat Bhumite Manusha Janma Haila Ja, Janma Sarthak Kari Karo Paro Upokar. Upokar, you can understand, it is very common word, to do something good to others, upokar. And apokar means to do something harm to others. At the present moment, throughout the whole world, the design is how to do something harmful to others. This is called envy. The material world is full of envies. I am envious of you and you are envious of me. This is materialism. The struggle between man to man, family to family, community to community, nation to nation, species to species, everyone is envious. This is material disease. And spiritual life means not to become envious. That is spiritual life. Therefore, in the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, Dharma Prajjita Kohitava Atra Parama Nirmasarana. This Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma. Bhagavad Dharma means the religious principles connecting with Bhagavan. That is Bhagavad, and that is Dharma. If the Dharma or the principle of religion does not try to understand God or to re-establish the relationship with God, that is not religion. That is cheating. Therefore, Bhagavad says, all types of cheating religion is rejected from Srimad Bhagavatam. We have manufactured so many religious systems, Hindu religion, Muslim religion, Christian religion, and so many others. Why religion should be designated? Just like gold. Gold is gold. There cannot be any Hindu gold or Muslim gold or Christian gold. Gold is gold. Everywhere you take gold, people will accept as gold. Because one Hindu is taking gold to some Muslim country, it does not mean the Muslims will not accept because it is brought by the Hindu. Gold is gold. Therefore, religion, the conception of religion must be gold. That is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Savai Pungshang Paro Dharma Jato Bhakti Radhukhaji. That is first class religion. Paro. Paro means transcendental, not material. Savai Pungshang Paro Dharma Jato Bhakti Radhukhaji. That system of religion is first class or transcendental, which teaches the followers how to become devotee of the Lord. That is religion. And that is instructed in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. That is religion. Krishna appeared, his mission was paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha duskritam dharma samsthapanarthaya yugi yugi sambhavan. So he appears for re-establishing the principles of religion. Now at the end of his instruction in the Bhagavad Gita, he says, sarva dharman parityajya. He did not appear to teach Hindu religion or Muslim religion or Christian religion. He appeared for teaching what is religion. Religion cannot be two. Religion is one. Man's religion should be one. That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Dharma, religion means the codes or the order given by God. That is religion. This is the simplest definition of religion. Dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Just like law means the codes or the order given by the state. You cannot manufacture law at your home. That is not possible. That is not law. What the state says, keep to the left or keep to the right, that is law. If you violate the law, then you will be punished. Similarly, the laws of God is the laws of material nature. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, maya adhyakshena prakriti svyate sa characharam. Just like the legislative assembly passes the law to be carried out, to be executed by the people in general, and if they do not do it, then they are punishable. Similarly, the dharma or the codes of Bhagavan you have to accept, compulsory. If you do not accept, then you will suffer. Mura janmani janmani, mam apraapoiva. This is the law. So human life is specially meant for understanding what is God and what is the law of God and how to follow it and achieve success in life. That is human life. Sambandha, avideya and prayojan. Sambandha means, first of all, we must understand what is our relationship with this material world or with God. So many there are, everything is relative. This is a relative world. So what is the relativity between God and ours? There must be God. The atheist class of men, they deny the existence of God. But that is superfluous. They cannot deny the existence of God because they have to abide by the laws of God. How you can deny the existence of God? Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Mrityu sarva harascha aham. The atheist class of men, they do not believe in God, but they believe in death. That they will have to believe. They cannot avoid. And Krishna says that death I am. If you do not believe in God, then you will have to believe me when I come as death and take everything from you. Mrityu sarva harascha aham. You may deny God and you may do whatever you like and you may create your own kingdom by plans. But when Krishna will come, he will come as death because you are atheist and he will take away everything what you have created. Just like Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu was atheist number one and he was very much persecuting his own son because he was a devotee of God, the only fault. So when it was very, very terrible, at that time Lord Srinivasadeva appeared and killed Hiranyakashipu within a second. So unless you make a solution of the four problems, namely birth, death, old age and disease, which is compulsory, how you can deny God? That is not possible. A madman says that I don't care for God, but no sane man will say like that. So God is there. I may believe or not believe, that is my business, but God is there. God's law are going on and we have to follow. We shall be forced to follow this way or that way. So there is no excuse to deny the existence of God. That is foolishness. Therefore, if you are sane man, then we should be sober. In cool head, we should think of how we are being controlled, who is the controller, why we are being controlled, why we are not independent, why we are forced to accept something which we do not want. These things have to be considered in human life, and that is the beginning of Vedanta Sutra. Athātha brahma jigyāsā. Now this human life is meant for inquiring about Brahma. That is the only business. That is the only business. Shastra says that tasyaiva hita prajatita kovida nalabhate jad bhramatam uparajadha. Everything is arranged according to the body I have received. How I have received this body? I have received this body by the material nature. Everyone can understand it. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimuratma katta ham iti mannate karanam gunasanga asya sadasat janmajunish. So, the prakriti is instrument through which God's law is working. That is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. The scientists are trying to make something new, but the real problem, janma mrityu jara vyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshanam, that is under the control of prakriti or the instrument of God. Now, how to make our life successful? That is being instructed by Rishabhdev to his sons. The first business, he says, na ayanga deha deho bhajanga niloke kastan kaman arhate birbhujangji. My dear sons, this life, ayanga deha, ayanga deha means this body, this human form of body. Devajang, loke, there are many other bodies. There are 8,400,000 forms of body. Jalajana galakhani sthavara lakhaminsati krimayo rudra sankhaka pakshinam dasa lakhakam then pasapa trimsa lakhani chatur lakhani manav. So, there are so many forms of life in this material world. Ayanga loke, deho bhajang means one, the spirit soul has accepted this body. But by evolutionary process, from aquatics to plants life, then insect life, then reptiles life, then birds life, beast life, then human form of life, then civilized form of life, then the life of human body born in Bharatvarsha. This is the highest developed life by evolutionary process. This land of Bharatvarsha. So, I am specially speaking to the Indians, Bharatvasi, that you have got this life in this land after many, many evolutionary process. Bahunam janmanamanti, bahusambhavanti. The Shastra says bahusambhavanti. Unfortunately, we are forgetting this. At the present moment, we are forgetting the importance of this life born in the land of Bharatvarsha. This is our misfortune. Don't be misled. You have got this human form of life, Bharatvasi. Very easily you can take the opportunity of understanding what is God, what is your relationship with God. Because in India there are so many Vedic Shastras. I am reading one, this Srimad Bhagavatam. This is also Vedic literature. It is the commentary on the Vedanta Sutra. Bhashang Brahma Sutrana. So, this Krishna consciousness movement means that we are spreading this knowledge of Srimad Bhagavatam throughout the whole world. And For the Indians, Bharatvasi, it is a special prerogative to understand these Vedic literatures and make his life successful. Do not spoil the gift, the boon given by God, this human form of life. Do not waste it for nothing. Utilize it. Therefore, long ago, about some millions and millions of years ago, this knowledge was imparted by Rishabhdev to his sons. My dear boys, you have got this human form of life, especially the body received from me. I am king in royal family, so don't spoil it. Nayang deho dehu bhajang nikole. How to spoil it? Kastana kaman. Simply for sense gratification, working very hard like an ass is not human form of life. Human form of life should be utilized to become very sober, cool-headed, and to understand what is God, what is my life. This is the necessity. Therefore, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Chaturvarnamaya Sistam Gunakarma Vibhaga. Not that everyone should be very much intelligent. It is not possible. Although everyone has got this human form of body, not that everyone is very intelligent. So according to the intelligence, the division should be there. That is confirmed by Krishna. Chaturvarnang maya sristam gunakarma vibhag. In the human society, there must be four divisions. The Brahmana, the Kshatriya, the Vaishya, and the Shudra, according to the quality. The most intelligent class of man, they should become Brahmanas. Satta, Sama, Dama, Titikha, Arjava, Jnanam, Vijnanam, Astikam, Brahma Karma Sabhava. So the next intelligent class of man should become the administrators. And the next intelligent class man should be the productive class, Vaishyas. Krishi Guruksha Vanijam Vaishya Karma Sabhava. Everything is there. Especially in India, this ideal life of human society should be inaugurated. We should not imitate the Western people who are now dwindling. Their material civilization is no longer giving them happiness. That is a fact. They are seeking after Athata Brahma Jigyasa. They are now seeking after inquiring about Brahma. Therefore, you find so many Europeans and Americans, they have taken to this Krishna consciousness movement because they are now inquisitive. Inquisitive, what is next? While we are following them, how to make machine and skyscraper building, they are coming to Krishna consciousness. So, long before, Rishabhdev advised, my dear sons, this body should not be misused, working whole day and night for sense gratification, because that is the business of the hogs and dogs. Yet it is clearly said, kastan kaman arhati birbhujang ji. Birbhujang, you have seen in our India we see birbhujang. Birbhujang means 2 liter. The pigs, they are seeking after stool. whole day and night, and they are eating. And after eating stool, the stool is very substantial food. According to chemical examination, it contains all the hypophosphites. Because the essence of the foodstuff we have taken, that is stool. So, anyone, if one can eat, but we can see that the hogs, they become very fatty. Because it contains fat. Sometimes in the war time, I learned that the German people are extracting fat from stool. So there is enough fat. The result is, they become very much sexually inclined. And they have no distinction how to enjoy sex life. Never mind, it is mother or sister or daughter, it doesn't matter. That is hog's life. Therefore, Rishabhdev is advising his sons, don't be like hogs. Eat very sumptuously, become fatty, and then seek after sex life, and without any discrimination, don't be like hogs and dogs. This life is not meant for to become like dogs and hogs. This is the first instance. Then what it is meant for? He says, Tapo dibbanga putraka. My dear sons, this life is meant for tapasya. Tapasya means voluntarily accepting some miseries. Just like we ask our students for tapasya, no illicit sex. So in the Western countries, it is very difficult to give up this habit. But these boys and girls, on my request, they have given up. This is called tapasya. I do not like to give up something. But for achieving some higher result, if I give up voluntarily something which may cause some miseries, still I shall accept it. That is called tapasya. Tapo. So, why tapasya? Tapasya is accepted for some higher achievement. So therefore it says, Tapo dibbam putraka. Dibbam. Dibbam means transcendent. Just like Krishna says, janma karma cha me dibbam. Dibbam. Transcendental divine. So Krishna says that janma karma cha me dibbam jo janati tattva. Anyone who tries to understand Krishna's activities, that is dibbam. So, tapo dibbam. My dear sons, accept tapasya for that transcendental realization, not for manufacturing atom bomb. That is also tapasya. The scientists undergo severe penances how to find out, discover some. Not that kind of, that is Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu, he also underwent great tapasya. But what was the result of that tapasya? To tease his own son because he was devout. Not that kind of tapasya. That is demonic. Tapo dibbam. Dibbam. You just try to undergo austerities and penances for divine transcendental realization. That is tapasya. Why I shall go? I am enjoying my senses very nicely, like the dogs and hogs. Why shall I undergo tapasya? No, the answer is given, tapo dibbam jena sattam suddhet. This tapasya is required if you want to purify your existence. Just like a man suffering from some disease, he is advised by the physician that you don't eat for some time, fast. That is tapasya. Why? Now, to be cured, to purify the body from the disease. That is tapasya. So, here tapasya is advised not for some material profit, but for transcendental realization. Then what will be the result? Suddheta satta, this existence at the present moment, my existence, this bodily existence is not pure. If it is pure, then why shall I be subjected to birth, death and old age? Because it is not pure. The so-called scientists, philosophers, they do not know. They say death is, it is inevitable. We cannot avoid it. No, death is, can be avoided. That is called tapasya, that is called purification. Just like Krishna says, tatta dehaṁ punar janma naiti, māmeti. Tatta dehaṁ punar janma naiti. After giving up this body, Krishna assures, then you don't get another material body. Where is that science? They do not know whether we are going to accept another body. That's a fact. But they do not know it. Big, big scientists, big, big professors, they do not know it. They think that this life is the end, and after this there is nothing, zero. Sunnavadi. Nirvishesha sunnavadi. But that is not the fact. Krishna says, tatha dehantara prapti. The most authorized person, Krishna. Who can be greater authority than Krishna? All acharyas accept. Ramanucharya, Madhvacharya, Shankaracharya, the acharyas who guide the destiny of Indian civilization, they accept Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. So how can you deny the statement of Krishna? Krishna says, tatha dehantara prati. As you are changing body in this life, dehinasmin jathate hi kaumaro jovanang jara, tatha dehantara prati. So there is dehantara prati. So this dehantara prati means disease condition. And we have accepted the so-called material happiness as happiness, but that may be happiness, but that is temporary. But real happiness, as it is stated here, that tapo dibbam putraka jena sattam shuddhe jasma brahma saukham manantam. If you purify your existence, that you are hankering after happiness, that happiness will be eternal. Eternal. Never interrupted. That is wanted. Ananda chinmaya rasa pratibhavitabhi. Ananda chinmaya rasa. Rasa means test. We test some happiness. But not this material happiness. But just like you test sugar candy when you are suffering from jaundice, the taste will be bitter. But sugar candy is not bitter, it is sweet. But when you are cured from the jaundice disease, the same sugar candy will be tasting very sweet. So we are hankering after tasting sugar candy in the disease condition. And and we are tasting the bitterness of it. But if you are cured, satya shuddhe, our existence is purified, then we shall taste brahma sukham to anantam, unlimited, eternal happiness. That is the business of human life. Not that for temporary happiness we shall work like hogs and dogs, perpetually, and getting cheat of another body. That is not very good intelligence. That will be described by Rishabhdev in the later verses. Nunam pramatta kuruti vikarma jadindriya pritaye aprinoti na sadhu manne jato atmaneyam asannapi klesha deyasadeha. This kind of working means I am creating another body. That we do not know. Neither this science is known to the modern civilized man. They are in ignorance. How we are creating another body? How there are so many different types of body? That is what jato atmanoyam asannapi klesho deyasadeha. This body is not permanent. But as long the body is there, you must suffer. You must suffer threefold miseries. That is not coming to our brain. We are accepting suffering as happiness. Asattare sattakari mani. Nitai pado pasariya ahankare matto hoiya. Asattare sattakari mani. You are accepting untruth as truth. This is our modern disease. It is not new, and some thousands and thousands of years ago, at least Srimad Bhagavat was written 5,000 years ago, and this instruction of Rishabhdev is there. So it must have had happened long, many years before this Bhagavat was written. So the same disease, because the material creation is not new. The disease is there from the very beginning. Now, in the Kali Yuga, the disease is very acute. Otherwise, the same birth and death, we have not improved anything, because the same birth and death is continuing. We are eating, sleeping, mating, and everything is going on. So, if we want to improve our position, if we want to enjoy life eternally, blissfully, then we must take to this Krishna consciousness movement. That is our request. If we don't take it compulsorily, then we are committing suicide. We are just trying to save the human society from this suicidal policy. So, my request is that it is a very scientific movement authorized from, taken from the Vedic literatures and based on the principles of Bhagavad Gita as it is. So, our only request is, especially here in India, they should take it very seriously and try to apply the principles in their life and spread it all over the world. That is the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Janma sarthak kari karo paropokar. We Indians, we are not meant for exploiting others. That is not our civilization. Cheating others, no, that is not ours. Our civilization is to do good to others. This is Indian civilization. Don't forget it. You have got a very exalted position. Take advantage of the shastras, make your life successful, and try to do good to others. Thank you very much. It is already described in the Bhagavad Gita that Karanam Gunasanga Asya Sadasat Janmajoni. There are different forms of life, different species of life. What is the reason of this different gradation? A dog's life and a man's life is different. How it has so become? What is the scientist's reply? I don't think the scientist can reply this. Or they can reply evolutionary process. How the evolutionary process is taking place? So that answer is also given in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya dhakshena prakriti svate sa characharam hetunani na kaunteya jagat bhi parivartate. The developed human life is obtained by karma, karmana daiva netrena jantar deha upapatti. We are working under the control of material nature and we are infecting, contaminating different modes of material nature. Just like a person who has contaminated the smallpox infection, he must suffer from smallpox. That is medical science. Similarly, karanam gunasangas. There are three material modes of nature: goodness, passion, and ignorance. See, if you associate with goodness, then your next body becomes manifest in the modes of goodness, just like highly intelligent class of man or the Brahmana. If you infect the modes of passion, then you become passionate, you get passionate body, and ignorance also. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattasthvā adho gacchanti tamasā. Jaghanna gunavittistha adho gacchanti tamasā. Every reply is there as you are associating or contaminating different modes of material nature. We are manufacturing or giving chance to get a certain type of body. Exactly, if I infect the smallpox disease, I must suffer from it. This is the law of nature. So, when after associating with the modes of goodness for many, many years, or not many, many years, but many, many lives, then one can become very intelligent Brahmana. Bahunam janmanamante jnanaman mana prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurna. After many, many births of this kind of contaminated diseases and births and body, when by culture of knowledge, by austerities, by penances, by Brahminical culture, one becomes very, very learned and wise. At that time he can understand what is God, not before. Bhavanam janmanamante jnanava. Not the rascals and the fools can understand what is God. Only the jnanava. So, as you are trying to become jnanava for higher status of life, Similarly, if you become Jnanavan to understand God, then God consciousness will come, not so easily. Manushanam sahasreshu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatam api siddhyanam kaschid vettimam tattata. So, not only ordinary human being, what they can understand about God. Manushanam sahasreshi kaschid jatati siddhaye. What is the perfection of life? One must know. The perfection of life is to understand that I am not this body. I am spirit soul, aham brahmasmi. That is perfection of life. When one can understand. Brahma bhuta prasannatma na sochati na kankati samas sarvesu bhuteshu mad bhakti labhati para. So, after becoming Brahma-realized soul, when he is fully liberated from material contamination, goodness, passion or ignorance, prasannātmā, na sūcati na kāṅkati, he has no material hankering, neither he laments for any material loss, samah sarvesu bhūteshu, when he visions all living entities as spirit soul, mad bhakti labhati panam. At that time he is eligible to understand what is bhakti. And bhaktyamam abhijanati javan jaschami tattva. If you become bhakta, if you have got the opportunity to come to that platform, then you can understand God. Otherwise God is not so easy to understand. What is your duty? That is the first thing. Do you know what is your duty? You manufacture your duty, but you do not know what is your duty. Duty is sarvadhanman parityajyamamekam saranam. That is your duty. Anything you manufacture, duty, that is not duty, that is cheating. First of all, you learn what is your duty. Then talk of duty. In your office, if you go, if you say, anything I do, it is my duty. No. You must know the particular work you are advised to act by the superintendent or the director. Not that you can manufacture your duty. If you execute that duty, then you are dutiful. Otherwise, you are simply creating trouble. Just like monkey, they create their duty. And wherever he goes, get out, get out, get out, get out. The monkey's duty is no duty. A man must know what is duty and he should execute, that is duty. Well, first of all, you try to understand Krishna, what he says. Then, if you are dutiful, then you can say, who is other dutiful? Krishna says, sarva-dharmān parityajya-māmekam saraṇam. If you come to that stage of life, then you are dutiful. Otherwise, if you create your duties like monkey, that is not duty. Hare Krishna.
I have been permitted to respectfully submit to the learner first question. Who raised by judgment entirely and exclusive on science and science alone? When the whole world is living wrong science, because science is responsible for every living thing and inanimate things, Why bring the Indian on the Lord? I cannot claim any superior knowledge than my dear personal, but I will service one way to service one answer that was given not by any gentleman or superior deputy preaching religion, but the greatest surgeon of the world. I do not mention the profession. There is a book of surgery written by two of the children of Harvard. They are from UK.
So, our endeavor should be not to be implicated by the material modes of nature, never mind what is the percentage. This material world is always mixed up. Some goodness, some passion, some ignorance. Here you cannot possess the material quality in full 100% purity. No, that is not possible. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. One quality is overlapping the other quality. Our business is how to become transcendental to all these qualities, not to be touched by any of the qualities of material nature. That is our vision. That should be our aim. Nirguna, that is called Nirguna. No more contaminated by the material quality. That is called Nirguna. That is very simple thing. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, मान चब्बै विचारिणी भक्ति योगेन जसेवते सगुणान समतीत एनान ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते मान चब्बै विचारिणी भक्ति योगेन जसेवते इफ वन एक्सेप्ट दिस भक्ति योग प्रोसेस श्रवणं कीर्तनं विष्णु स्मरणं पाद सेवनं अर्चनं वंदनं दासं सखम आत्मनिवेदन दीज आर द डिफरेंट नाइन items of bhakti yoga. If you take all of them or some of them or at least one of them, you become transcendental to all these material qualities. Sagunan samatita itan. All these material qualities one can transcend and remain in the Brahma platform. Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpate. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasuchati Nakam. This is the process. It is not that we shall possess this quality, certain percentage, that quality, certain percentage. No. Above all qualities. That should be the aim of life. Then we shall be in the Brahma platform or in the spiritual platform. And then our life will be successful. Otherwise, struggle for existence. Bhutta bhutta priyate. We take one type of body according to the contamination of material modes of nature. We suffer and enjoy. Then again we die. Again we accept another body. In this way it continues and we remain entangled in this material world. Yeah. It is said in the Shastra, Atha Sri Krishna Namadi Nabhavet Graiham Indriyai Sevan Mukhihi Jivado Swamiva Spurata. Krishna, his form, his name, his quality, his pastime, his paraphernalia cannot be experienced by these material senses. Atha Sri Krishna Namadi Navabe Graiham Indriya. He is beyond the Indriyas. But if one is engaged in devotional service, Sevan Mukhihi Jivado, that devotional service begins from jiva, tongue. that strong means can be utilized in devotional service in two ways, namely by chanting the holy name of God and by tasting prasadam. If first of all one engages his jivha, means tongue, in devotional service by chanting the holy name Hare Krishna Mahamantra and tasting only Krishna prasadam, not anything else, then Krishna being pleased by his devotional service, he manifests himself, reveals himself. That revelation is experienced. Very highly advanced devotee. So, for advanced devotee, everything is possible as described by this gentleman. But that is not for everyone. That is not a common thing, exception. For the common person, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has advised and as he has practically shown in his life, that is devotional service in separation. Where is Krishna? Sunnayitam jagasarvam govinda virahena me. I am seeing everything vacant because I cannot see Krishna. The same thing was followed by the Goswamis. He Radhi Brajadevi ki chalalite, he Nanda Suna Kutaha. Where you are? O Radharani, O Krishna, O the Gopis, where you are? He Radhi Brajadevi ki chalalite, he Nanda Suna Kutaha. See Govardhana Padapatale Kalindivane Kutaha. Govardhana Padapatale, either on the valley of the Govardhan hill or on the bank of the Ganges, where you are or seeking. Ghosantaviti Sarvato Brajapure Kedai Mahabhur. One should be mad after seeking Krishna. Where you are, where you are. Not that I have seen. That is not bhajan. Bhajan means how to become mad after Krishna. One who has once heard the tinkling sound of his ankle bell, he will be mad after him. Where you are, where you are. Not that hearing and become engaged in the family affairs. No. That is not possible. One who has seen, one who has heard, he will become mad. No more interest in this material affair. That is the sign. We can say, of course, if you are experienced devotee, but so far we see of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his immediate success as Goswamis, they are mad after Krishna. They never say that we have seen Krishna. This is called bhajan by separation, vipralamba seva. So, if we become mad after Krishna, that is perfection. Not that we have seen Krishna. We may see, but so far the Goswamis are concerned, they are simply seeking. Gosantaviti Sarvato Brijapure Khedai Mahabhuval. Bhuval means mad. Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? That is self-realization. Thank you very much. Chant Hare Krishna.